Hello, I'm Maruk Said, your microbiology guide. Let's explore in-depth micro techniques and uncover groundbreaking insight together on this educational journey into the fascinating realms of microbes.
16S rRNA gene sequencing, exploring microbial diversity and its applications. Table of contents. Introduction. What is the 16S rRNA gene? Principle of 16S rRNA gene sequencing. Steps involved in 16S rRNA gene sequencing. Advantages of 16S rRNA gene sequencing. Limitations of 16S rRNA gene sequencing. Applications of 16S rRNA gene sequencing. Introduction. 16S rRNA gene sequencing is an amplicon-based method used to identify and classify bacteria in complex biological samples. This technique leverages the highly conserved 16S ribosomal RNA, rRNA, gene found in all prokaryotes, which contains variable regions that distinguish between species. The use of 16S rRNA for bacterial identification was first introduced by Carl Woese and George E. Fox in 1977. Traditional culture-based methods for species identification in bulk samples are labor-intensive and time-consuming, often detecting only a small portion of microbial species. The adoption of 16S rRNA as a marker for organism identification, combined with the advancement of next-generation sequencing, NGS techniques, has enabled the rapid and efficient analysis of numerous samples. This approach has led to the identification of many sequences from previously uncultured species. If you have watched till here, don't forget to subscribe to Family of Science Lovers. Press the bell icon button so you are always updated. What is the 16S rRNA gene? The 16S rRNA gene sequence is the most widely used genetic marker for investigating bacterial taxonomy and phylogeny. Ribosomes are essential cellular structures involved in protein synthesis, consisting of two subunits composed of proteins and ribosomal RNA, rRNA. The rRNA plays a key role in translating the information encoded in messenger RNA, mRNA, into proteins. In prokaryotes, ribosomes are made up of a 30S subunit and a 50S subunit, which together form a complete 70S ribosome. The S stands for Svedberg unit, which is a measure of sedimentation rate. The 30S subunit specifically contains 16S rRNA and 21 proteins. The 16S rRNA gene, approximately 1,500 base pairs in length, features variable regions interspersed between conserved regions. The conserved regions are crucial for universal amplification of the gene, while the variable regions are instrumental in distinguishing specific microorganisms. These variable regions are particularly valuable for the identification and classification of bacteria. The conserved regions of the 16S rRNA gene exhibit similarity across various bacterial species, making them ideal targets for universal primers that can amplify the gene from a wide range of bacteria. The variable regions of the 16S rRNA gene show sequence diversity among different species, enabling the differentiation and identification of bacteria within diverse microbial environments. These regions are utilized for the phylogenetic classification of distinct microbial populations. The 16S rRNA gene contains 9 hypervariable regions, known as V1 through V9. Principle of 16S rRNA gene sequencing. The principle of 16S rRNA gene sequencing relies on amplicon sequencing, which targets specific regions of the genome. This method uses the genetic information encoded in the 16S rRNA gene to identify and classify bacterial and archaeal species. The 16S rRNA gene serves as a reliable marker for the identification of these microorganisms, as it is universally present and highly conserved across all bacteria and archaea. The process of 16S rRNA gene sequencing includes several key steps: DNA extraction, PCR amplification of the 16S rRNA gene, sequencing, bioinformatics analysis. Steps involved in 16S rRNA gene sequencing. 1. Sample collection. The first step is the collection of microbial samples from the environment of interest, which can include sources such as soil, water, or biological samples like the gut microbiome. Different procedures are used for collecting different types of samples, and it is critical that sample collection and processing are conducted in a way that minimizes the risk of contamination. Before isolating DNA, contaminants should be removed through pretreatment methods, which may include the use of enzymes, heat, or physical techniques. 2. DNA extraction. After samples are collected, the next step is to extract microbial DNA using various extraction techniques. DNA extraction involves several chemical and physical methods to isolate the DNA from the samples. This process includes physical disruption methods such as sonication, chemical lysis with detergents and enzymes, and purification steps to ensure that the DNA is free of impurities and ready for further analysis. 3. PCR and library construction. This step prepares the DNA for sequencing. The first part of the step involves amplifying the 16S rRNA gene using polymerase chain reaction, PCR. It is essential to optimize the PCR conditions and select appropriate primers to avoid non-specific amplification and achieve accurate results. Following amplification, the DNA is processed to create a library for sequencing. This involves fragmenting the amplified DNA into shorter segments and attaching adapters to these fragments. The library is then purified to remove any excess adapters and primers, ensuring that the DNA fragments are of uniform size for efficient sequencing. 4. Sequencing. The prepared library is then subjected to high-throughput sequencing using platforms such as Illumina, IonTorrent, Oxford Nanopore, or PacBio. During this step, the DNA libraries are amplified and sequenced, generating millions of short DNA sequences simultaneously. The resulting raw sequence data undergoes quality control and bioinformatics analysis to identify and classify the microbial communities present in the sample. 5. Data analysis. After sequencing, the final step is data analysis. The sequencing data is processed using various bioinformatics tools to interpret the results. This process includes several steps, such as trimming the reads to ensure quality, removing sequences that do not belong to the target domain, clustering reads into operational taxonomic units, OTUs, aligning OTUs with a reference database, and assigning taxonomic identities to the OTUs. Tools like KeyIME, Mother, and USearch UpArce are commonly employed for these tasks, offering tutorials and user-friendly interfaces. Once the sequencing results are matched to databases, statistical methods are applied to uncover patterns and relationships between different samples. If you have watched till here, don't forget to subscribe to Family of Science Lovers. Press the bell icon button so you are always updated. Advantages of 16S rRNA gene sequencing. The 16S rRNA gene is conserved across bacteria and archaea, yet it contains enough sequence variation to differentiate between species. This characteristic makes it an exceptionally effective tool for identifying and comparing microbial communities. Unlike traditional culture-based methods, 16S rRNA gene sequencing enables the direct study of microbial communities from environmental samples, including those containing unculturable microbes. High-throughput sequencing technologies facilitate the simultaneous sequencing of thousands of 16S rRNA gene fragments, enabling large-scale analyses of microbial communities. Traditional laboratory culture techniques rely on phenotypic characteristics and biochemical reactions, which can be subjective and susceptible to contamination. In contrast, 16S rRNA gene sequencing protocols incorporate rigorous quality control measures and validated bioinformatics pipelines to ensure the accuracy and reliability of the results. Limitations of 16S rRNA gene sequencing. The 16S rRNA gene can only differentiate bacteria up to certain taxonomic levels. Closely related bacterial species often exhibit high sequence similarity in their 16S rRNA genes, making it challenging to distinguish them with precision. As a result, the method often falls short in accurately resolving species-level differences. High sequence similarity in the 16S rRNA gene does not always guarantee precise species identification. Processing and analyzing the complex sequencing data generated by this method requires specialized bioinformatics tools and expertise. Compared to shotgun sequencing, 16S rRNA gene sequencing generally offers lower taxonomic resolution. Since 16S rRNA gene sequencing targets only a single gene, it is unable to identify the functional roles of the microbial community. Applications of 16S rRNA gene sequencing. 16S rRNA gene sequencing is a powerful tool for determining the species composition and community structure of microbial populations within complex biological samples. This approach enables the study of microbial diversity and provides insights into how microbial communities interact within their ecosystems. In clinical microbiology, 16S rRNA gene sequencing is employed to investigate microbial communities associated with diseases. This aids in understanding the mechanisms of disease and in the development of targeted treatments. This technique is also valuable for identifying and classifying microorganisms in a variety of environmental samples, such as soil and water. In the food industry, 16S rRNA gene sequencing can be used to study microorganisms in fermented foods and to identify foodborne pathogens. This contributes to food safety by enabling the identification of microbial communities present in food products. In agriculture, this method is utilized to enhance crop health by examining the microbial communities associated with soil and plants. The study of the human microbiome also benefits from 16S rRNA gene sequencing, as it allows researchers to explore microbial diversity and its impact on human health. Additionally, comparing bacterial 16S rRNA sequences can lead to the discovery of novel species. Examples of applications of 16S rRNA gene sequencing include the Human Microbiome Project, which characterizes human-associated microbial communities, the Global Ocean Sampling Expedition, which explores microbial diversity in the oceans, soil microbiome studies, research into antibiotic resistance in hospitals, and monitoring microbial communities in wastewater treatment facilities. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, press the bell icon button. Thank you!